Being an extremely respected military member, Lieutenant Colonel Mark Weber has seen his share of battles, but none like the one that he's currently facing. Even more than the battle itself, it's how he's handling it that's inspiring people across the nation.
My name is Mark Weber. I'm an active duty lieutenant colonel in the Army, and I'm dying of terminal cancer. Tell My Sons is essentially 9 long letters to my boys.
Tell my father that his son didn't run or surrender. That I bore his name with pride as I tried to remember. You are judged by what you do while passing through.
The message that I'm trying to send with the book is, you know, life is unfair. What do you do and what do you say when, to your kids, to your family, to your friends, when life doesn't go the way that you want it to?
And joining us this morning is Lieutenant Colonel Mark Weber. Lieutenant, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you for having me.
We want to kind of set up a little bit about this story and where we're going to go with this. Now, 2 years ago, you were in the peak of a 16-year career as an Army officer, having just been handpicked by General David Petraeus to work with the Afghan Parliament. And then 2 weeks later, at age 38, and with 3 young boys, and a wife of 16 years, you were diagnosed with stage 4 cancer. You underwent a massive surgery that it failed, and then you were given 4 months to live. So
yeah.
Where are you at right now? How long ago was that?
That was 2.5 years ago.
When you were given 4 months to live.
Right.
So that in itself is extremely inspiring.
Right, right.
How do you find the strength?
well, continuing to be me, first of all. I mean, I start with a laugh because it's, I don't know, there's a little humor aside astride the tragedy and the crisis of things. But that was when I received the 4 months to live diagnosis, that was my 3rd misdiagnosis in 3 years.
Wow.
And so I received a total of 5 diagnoses. So on the 5th diagnosis, it was intestinal cancer, and so we were able to start treating it properly. But we've never quite been ahead of the cancer, so it's slowly growing. I'm on my 4th chemo trial, and you know, how do I do it? When I go out and I speak to people, and I can feel the power in the room, like I'm energizing them, and that's what I want to do with the days that I have left. That inspires me to just keep doing it. You know, when you've got grown men coming up to you and they've got tears in their eyes, and they're like, "This has changed my life." I never would have imagined being able to do something like that. So, you know, it's a tragedy about how we've gotten to this point, but it's a beautiful thing to see what I'm able to do with it.
And part of this has been a book that you wrote to your boys,
right,
which was started with some letters that you put together. Tell
right.
us about that.
Well, I kept journals for 20 years. Ugly, you know, you just write everything down because you don't know what the heck is important. If you knew, then,
yep.
You know.
Yep.
And, you know, when I received the diagnosis, I looked at those journals and I saw that I had 20 years of gobbledygook and I left them a chore. So I went to work just kind of pulling out some of the most important or what I thought were the compelling stories of my life. Not as advice, but just, you know, here's one path and this is what I've done. And for God's sake, don't follow me on some of this stuff. It's just perspective. And as I continue to survive, I realized that I needed to turn this 600 pages into something that was more concise. Because just like the public, you don't get to write War and Peace on stuff. You know, get to the point.
Sure. Well, what are you hoping that the children, that your boys take away from this, and that everyone else out there takes away from the book?
I am actually hoping less about what people will take away from the book because, you know, the feedback that I'm getting is unbelievable. I mean, I wrote it for my boys because I have a responsibility as a father, you know, to pass along the things that I won't be able to do since I'm, you know, I'm going to be gone.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, what do you do when life doesn't go the way that you want it to? Well, you know, this and that, and I want to blame this person. And yes, I hear what you're saying, but you didn't answer the question. What are you going to do about it? And that doesn't necessarily mean everything's going to turn out great. But if you stick to that prescription with discipline, you'll find that through trying, you'll find something. And you just got to keep trying.
And this is the message that you're taking out. This is the message that you're, when you're able to get out and speak to people, yeah. This is the message that makes people who are healthy and seemingly happy and complaining about their life.
Which I never stop them from complaining.
Sure.
In fact, when people tell me, I'm not going to complain to you because, you know, you've got what you've got. Don't diminish your own hardship. I don't want you to have what I have. But you can learn from me and from people like me who, like people say, I can't imagine doing what you do. Right, you can't. So don't use your imagination. Just follow me. Look at what I'm doing. You know, trust what I'm telling you. And do that, and you'll find what I'm finding, you know? And that's like the message throughout the book. It's stories that I wrap around morals on life, you know, because you got to have a framework. But the stories are, some of them are fun, you know? People apologize to me for laughing and crying at the same story, and they apologize. I'm like, don't apologize. That's the sweet spot.
Well, we're going to get into a little bit of the if we can laugh about things,
yeah.
There are lots of things that he's going to make us laugh about. And we're going to talk about that when we continue our conversation with Lieutenant Colonel Weber. That's coming up in the next half hour. We hope you stick around for that. Once again, by Lieutenant Colonel Mark Weber, who at the peak of a very distinguished military career was diagnosed with terminal cancer. Now, faced with the reality that his three sons might grow up without their father, he wrote the book, Tell My Sons, and that's inspiring people all across the nation. And thanks for joining us again, Lieutenant Colonel, to talk a little bit more about this. We've given you some extended time today because we just think your message is so inspirational. Before you get to how you can find laughter in all this, kind of tell us where the prognosis stands right now for you.
Well, they stopped giving me prognoses. I mean, you saw the picture in the screen. You know, I've got maybe 15% of my liver left, and I'm yellow. I have yellow eyes, and that's jaundice. So prognosis is live every day, and I had that philosophy before cancer, and I think you've got to have that regardless of what's sitting in front of you.
You had said something, and I don't want to say anything too adult for the children who might be in the audience, but flip a certain finger at cancer,
yes.
At your situation, whatever it is.
Yes.
I mean, I think for a lot of people, they think, well, how could you find anything to laugh about in this?
Yeah. Well, the middle finger is about, it's a 2,000-year-old concept of contempt. But for me, it's about what are you going to do when people tell you that you can't do something? So like this book, I started writing this book in July, and there was interest at the national level, and, you know, they said it's going to be 2 years. I don't have 2 years. We're doing this now.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't, you know, good luck. And then I found a collaborator to work with me just to serve as an objective set of eyes, and he said, a healthy person, when do you want to get it done by? And I said, by Christmas, because that's how long I thought I had. He said, a healthy person can't get it done in 6 months. You're dying. And I said, okay. Can't. That's all I need to hear. And I got it done in 6 weeks.
Wow.
And so that's like, was I 100% sure I was going to get it done? No. But I was going to try, you know, and I got there. And I've usually found that just doing your best at something gets you to where you want to go.
And your book has been getting accolades from, many, many different people. Too many to even get into, but Robin Williams, he even wrote the foreword to the book, correct?
Yes.
How'd that happen?
Well, I crossed paths with him in 2004. I planned the USO tour when I worked in the Pentagon for the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff. I planned and organized the USO tour. We go around all the countries and do, and Robin Williams was one of the mm-hmm. players, and so was John Elway. And so I reached out to them and asked for help, and they did. They read it and said it was just awesome. And, I mean, that's good, because you write something in 6 weeks, you got to concede that it might be not so good.
Some people spend their whole life writing a book and maybe feel right. Like it's not good enough.
Right, so. Right.
And most of those books don't mean as much as this one does.
Right.
I mean, this is something real
personal
that you wrote to your family.
Yeah. And you know, heavy topics, but it doesn't need to be a heavy discussion. You know, and that's what I try to encourage people. There's some people who say, well, I'm afraid to read it because of some experience that I've had. And I'm like, I didn't create a brick for my boys. I wanted something that will encourage them and empower them, that the phrase, you can do it, is more than just some quaint, you know, pep talk. It's a charge of responsibility. You can do it. Don't say you can't. You might not want to, but you can. Just try. Just one step further, one step further. I mean, any parent out there can see doing this with their kids, but in specific ways.
Well, Mark, we thank you so much for stopping by today, talking to us about your journey, talking to us about something that I guess is inspiring people not only here in Minnesota, where you're from, but all around the country. So if you're interested in learning more about this book, it's called Tell My Sons. We've made it easy for you to find some info. Just go to our website, go to KSTP.com, click on links. We wish you the best of luck. You know what? They gave you 4 months, how many years ago?
2.5 years.
All right. Well, we're going to keep pulling for you, okay?
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Joyce.
There you go. Well, you know.